As I said, BNR technology is a fork in the road, and what we see now is the formation of granular activated sludge. Now, the activated sludge process was discovered about 100 years ago, and it's a selection process. Whatever settles, you keep and grow that again. What doesn't settle, you wash out. So you end up with the stuff that settles. And so we have seen this granular formation. In fact, in that first plant in 1914, they've already seen the granules. But I think what has happened recently, the Dutch developed this process in which they wash out all the other material and just leave the granules. And the granules settle so fast that they use a process that would help that. But I just wanted to mention this because this is a sequencing batch reactor. That's an alternative way of doing activated sludge, obviously, in which instead of settling it separately and return it, you just settle it in the same basin. You have alternative basins and you keep feeding them and they go around. So this plant had to be an SBR, or sequencing batch reactor as it was called. And the problem here was, I mentioned the SVI further. In order for this plant to work, we had to have a low SVI. And when we started up the plant, the SVI was like 180, where it should have been 60 to 70. And it was dire straits. So we started feeding into the sludge blanket during the feed period into the sludge blanket and decant from the top. It made the operation a lot simpler. And we started growing much heavier sludge, and that value dropped to 50, and by that we could get 120% of the design flow through the plant. Now this plant is built on a postage stamp, as you can see. The dimensions is enormous. This is like 160, 170 feet. One of these tanks, there are 24 of them and they're stacked. And one of the advantages of this process is that you could put the columns through the bottom tanks because there's no moving parts inside except the aeration stones. And they work in sequence. As that red line is about the size of a football field. So you can see how much, how concentrated it was. But here we grew this heavy sludge, and here is another plant in which you can see this sort of granular sludge formation, but you still have growth going out of them. And when we started wasting from the surface, we dropped the SVI to about 20 milliliters. That's very much below what you normally see. But unfortunately, at that point, we started seeing some turbulence in the effluent. So now they waste from the bottom and the top, and they can control that density of the sludge very well. This is just a picture of that. But the Dutch process that they developed is an SVR again. And what they do is they feed during decant, just like we did in the Dublin plant. And they feed into the sludge blanket, but distributed evenly over the floor. So what you then have is these granules, and it's designed in such a way that there's enough turbulence to any growth that wants to, like these filaments that would grow out of the granules, with the turbulence and also with the aeration, they get broken off and get washed out. And so you select for an organism or a set of organisms. It's the same type of organisms as we will see. I just want to show you here, this is treating mostly septage. And look at that variation in COD. As I said, normal wastewater is like at 400, and this is 800 to 10,000 and coming out at 100, which means the BOD was virtually nil. And nitrogen going out. Yeah, this is the other feature of this. Because of the module of the granules formed, they find nitrification taking place on the outside and denitrification on the inside. And then on top of that, it removes phosphorus. So this is, and then it settles so fast that what you see here is after 20 minutes of settling, these granules settle just like little rocks. Whereas this is the normal activated sludge. Now, normal activated sludge would look like this. You would have a flock that is fluffy and is difficult to settle, and that's why the settling tanks have to be so big. But if you can, it's the same organisms, there's nothing different, it's just the way you operate the plant. you can grow these granules, and when you aerate, there's more air on the inside, there's a gradient inside here in the flock, so you get the nitrifiers growing on the outside, then the denitrifiers, and then they also get phosphorus removal in the same process. And we are seeing this making inroads right now. Now, we've got very many plants here that we still have to convert, and they are not, it's not, so we cannot abandon the plants we have. So we're still gonna have these plants side by side. But the newer plants, we may see more of these happening. This is a plant in the Netherlands where you see three of these tanks, and that's it. And they had filtration on here. Initially, you have to wash out those extra organisms that grow, and they had filtration, but they don't do filtration anymore on this now. This is what it looks like. You can actually see the granules in there. And this is an example of how much smaller the footprint is. And this is the existing plant, and this is about the same size for these upflow units. And here you see one is under aeration, and the distributions are set, the flow is in the bottom, so it works its way through the granules while it's under anaerobic conditions, and then they start the aeration process. And then during the feeding process, it decants the cleaner water on top. So it, as you feed it, it pushes the cleaner water out at the top part. So they won this basically just on cost. And here I've been visiting the plant, and you can see these granules of activated sludge form.